Evening, everybody. Thank you very much for that warm applause. I hope it's just as warm when I'm going off. A horse, my kingdom for a horse. Tis it not nobler to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune? You got a better round of applause for Shakespeare before. So, most men my age who are careering rapidly towards a midlife crisis would opt maybe for a faster car, or if they're really lucky, a faster woman. I've decided to have a go at stand-up comedy, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, where else can you expose yourself, not like that, to ridicule, laughter, to be judged by the public, other than Love Island, obviously. And let's be perfectly honest, I ain't getting on Love Island anytime soon, unless they have an over-50s version. But yes, I am. Oh, then again, I could get myself a younger woman. I mean, it's not beyond the realms of capability. It may involve a small amount of Rohypnol. Or because I'm more traditional, chloroform. But I'm at that kind of age. I am a child of the 70s. I mean, judging by some of you in the audience tonight, you've probably only heard about the 70s in history books. But it was a very interesting decade. A lot of famous celebrities are trying to forget about the 70s. Thanks to Operation U-Tree. Even Cliff Richard wasn't safe. And whoever had the doubts about Cliff Richard, eh? But back when I was a kid, if you wanted to meet somebody famous, you used to write a letter. Didn't you? You used to write a letter to Jim will fix it. Jim will fix it for you to need years of therapy because he fiddled with you on his big red chair. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I wrote a letter to Jim will fix it, and this is the truth. Thank fuck I never got an answer. Because I asked to meet Ralph Harris. A true story. I may have just dodged a Jim and Ralph spit roast back then. I shudder at the thought. But now at my age, I have a 16-year-old daughter. Exactly, someone had to sharp and take a breath then. And the thing about having a 16-year-old daughter is you worry about them. And I also don't like teenagers. But my daughter said to me, Dad, can I come and see you at the gig? And I'm thinking, oh, she must be dead proud of me. She wants to come and support me. And I quote, so I can come and watch you crash and burn. And that is a real quote. I only tolerate it because I might need a kidney one day. But yet, so on the list of teenagers I don't like, and no offense, although you should all be over 18, teenage boys is at the top of the list of people I don't really like. And now my daughter has got a boyfriend, ladies and gentlemen. She has got a boyfriend. So she has infected our home with a teenage boy. She has exposed our family, not like that again, but to a teenage boy. And she asked me the question, can he stay over? Well, I say she asked me through her mum. And I'm not going to say no, because I like to think I'm, you know, quite a cool dad. I mean, I don't really know what a cool dad means. I don't know whether it means you do drugs together. You know what? My dad's cool because he was there to phone the ambulance last time I OD'd. I don't think I'm in that realm of cool. But you've got to agree to these things. And I'm just thinking, oh, I don't know how I'm going to deal with this. I smoked 2 packets of cigarettes on the day he was staying, right? I don't even smoke. Like, that's always a bad start. But not only sleep over, but in the same room. Cool dad, you know what I mean? Don't do drugs, but your boyfriend can sleep over. And for me, personally, it was quite a hard time because I used to go to bed listening to whale music. If you've not tried it, it's really good, seriously. You just drift off to Never Neverland listening to those tones drift off to sleep. Not when the boyfriend's staying, I don't. I listen to Planet Rock. Loudly. Because there's some things you just don't want to hear. Especially when they're having more fun than me. Another downside of being old, you see. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I forgot the rest of me set. So if you want to riff or you want to heckle, please don't. But you've been absolutely fantastic. Thank you very much.